Rondo. Rondo will inbound. 11.7 seconds remaining in a four-point game. NBA championship coming down to the final seconds.
You're Lamar Odom playing inbounds pass, and you should recognize where the shooters are coming off.
Rondo looking, gets it to Pierce. Pierce turns, back out. Rondo fakes, dribbles, puts up the three, won't go. Rebound to Saul, kicks it out to Odom. Odom throws it ahead. The Lakers repeat back-to-back titles. The LA Lakers, the 2010 NBA champions. Center as the Lakers win their 16th title, and this has to be one of the sweeter ones as they defeat the Celtics finally in a game seven, and are now just one title behind Boston for the most NBA championships. And what a hard-fought physical game seven this was. Had to come back from 13 down in the second half. Pau Gasol, the emotions flowing as he wins his second straight championship.
But we keep going strong with hands stretched to the sun. Look back at those before, see the things we have done. Cause you can't know where to go if you don't know where you come from. Where you come from, where you come from. Yeah, if you don't know where you come from. Yeah, where you come from.
Started from the bottom, now we here. No, we started at the top, then they brought us over here. Raped us of our heritage and identity. Lynched our leaders, now they just memories. The 13th Amendment, say we are free, but it's a crime being black, so that don't apply to me. The penitentiary is the new plantation. Rich versus poor is the new segregation. Cut us off as a nation with a crafty council. Don't believe me, it's real. It's all in the Bible. Made us worship idols like Cesare Borgia with them baby blue eyes and that long blonde hair. No, I'm not biased, nor am I racist, but it's time that we get back to the basics. Unplugged from the matrix, like Morpheus, I give the glory to the Father, cause he's glorious, come on.
We keep working hard, stay too tired to run, but we keep going strong, with hands stretched to the sun. Look back at those before, see the things we have done, cause you can't know where to go. Yeah. You don't know where you come from.
They say we started from the bottom, now we here. No, we started at the top, then they brought us over here. We helped build this country that you call America. With blood, sweat, and tears, but they still unfair to us. War against drugs, man, that's the big hoax. Cause we don't own any planes or any boats. Flood the hood with Jodo, aim for the poor folk who can't find a job. So it ain't no hope, destroying my community. Police treat us brutally, the average black male is see jail before puberty. But in the suburbs, they do the same thing. So why are we the only ones locked up in chains? To them it's a game, for us it's a trap. Like a rat chasing cheese in the maze. And it's the fact that we spend a lot of money but have nothing to show. How we gon' get where we going if we don't know where to go? For real.
We keep working hard, stay too tired to run. But we keep going strong, with hands stretched to the sun. Look back at those people, see the things we have done.
Yeah, or Jones,
you don't know where you come from.
That wasn't your name. how did he take it? What tongue did you speak? How did the man take your tongue? Where is your history? How did the man wipe out your history? How did the man, what did the man do to make you as dumb as you are right now?
Kicked off my shoes and ran out.
Yeah, yeah.
Kicked off my shoes and ran out. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Kicked off my shoes and ran a mile through my mind. A couple laps around the track, I thought I'd lose every time. My sight is doing fine, cause all I see is dollar signs and famous people, so I know pretty soon the world gon' be mine. I'm caught in demonstrations where the women be contemplating dating me, and the realization that somebody's always hating, that really gets me thinking. So out this bottle I'll be drinking till I can't feel nothing else but the drums on this song beating. My heart beating just a little irregular, because my other half is missing, I need to be next to her. So I'ma try to fill it, filling up all of these women, trying not to catch feelings, think of her while I am drilling. That's the crazy thing about this life that we live in. You can have it all and still want something different. I'm learning every day, focus more on giving. This is for everybody that don't get it. Look, winter, spring, summertime, I'm a real person. Rainfall, thundershine, I'm a real person. My name, dog, you can find under real person. Yeah, yeah. Look, winter, spring, summertime, I'm a real person. Rainfall, thundershine, I'm a real person. My name, dog, you can find under real person. I might just keep going. Yeah, feel like I took the pill from Limitless, cause I've been on some different shit. Differences between me and you, I'm sick, you just in bed. Could've made Luther King route, but chose school instead. Went ahead and got them student loans, now gotta choose again. Always remember, you can lose your life in this shit. It's all one big game, and I'm just striking this bitch. I mean, if I'm going down at all, then I'm going down fighting. Got this alcohol in me, so you know I'm not frightened. I'm just coping, trying to lighten all the pressure on me. I mean, some days I feel like Akon, cause I'm Mr. Lonely. R.I.P. to Darian, I can't forget you, homie. I got so caught up with this music, I ain't checking on you. I often front about how I'm feeling when I'm with my homies, cause you was there before the songs, back when my hair was long. And I know you think you probably never left impression on me, but lil bro was so in awe that you was so 6'4". And every time I passed the ball, it was assist, so for sure. Keep going. We used to run the halls in the 6th grade. Now sometimes you make me ball in a different way. I feel ashamed I never called but sent you them links. Now I realize this shit is not at all what you would think. Now I miss them summers in them AAU leagues. Flying Eagles Gold was the name of the team that I played on. Damn, how in the fuck could they spray on? A lanky ass light skinned dude thin as a crayon. Smile like your mom, she lit up when you would play on. You taught me how to fight tall niggas back in Fame Yard. Remember back when we was kids, nowadays these niggas ain't hard. You never get to choose the hand you dealt, that's why I hate cards. I wish that I could call you dog, I really hate. Winter, spring, summertime, I'm a real person. Rainfall, thundershine, I'm a real person. My name, dog, you can find under real person. Winter, spring, summertime, I'm a real person. Rainfall, I'm a real person. My name, dog, you can find under real person. Now I'm actually kind of getting choked up by that nigga D. Rest in peace to my childhood friend, man, Darian McLaurin. And I don't know, rest in peace to a lot of friendships that I lost chasing this little dream and just being hella focused on myself and shit, being selfish. Valuable time with like people in your life or relationships that you could have had. I made valid. I get so focused on that shit. I don't know, man. It's a long ass song. I didn't even really mean for this shit to be that long. I originally wrote this shit for it to be a fucking, like, you know, chart topping, you know, deep song. Everybody could yell, everybody could scream. But now it's just some real shit, you know. It's on some winter break type shit. The real one's what I'm talking about. TBKTR forever and a day, man.
The NBA is currently in an entertainment crisis. And the reason why they're currently in an entertainment crisis is because players are being pressured to do too much. You got a lot of voices talking to them. You got people on the endorsement side telling them that they have to be more than an athlete. You have childhood friends telling them that they have to be more than an athlete. You got people on social media telling them that they have to be more than an athlete. Entertainment. So many people telling them to do so many things where it's distracting them from focusing on basketball. Now, there's nothing wrong with being more than an athlete. But it becomes an issue when you forsake your true purpose of playing in the NBA. And that true purpose, basketball is number one. And basketball has to be priority number one. And for a lot of these guys, basketball has not been priority number one. And it's a shift that I've noticed. It started within the past decade where players were just started to be satisfied. It didn't matter if they got eliminated out of the first round of the playoffs. It didn't matter if they had a 10 game losing streak during the regular season. It was just whatever. I remember growing up watching basketball where there were certain cities where it was unacceptable for you to lose to. It was certain teams where it was just unacceptable for you to lose for teams that were good to lose to. The Hawks, the Magic, are two to name a few. But in today's NBA, if you lose to one of the worst teams in the league, it's just like, whatever. It's like guys don't care. It's like that passion, that hunger to be great, it's lacking. So when you see a guy like Dr. J don't mention any of today's NBA players, Gen Ys and Gen Zs, as in his top 10 of favorite players of all time. You gotta understand. We have to understand. A guy like Dr. J comes from a different era. An era where it was not okay for you to sit out multiple games unless you were truly hurt. It was not okay for you to sit out a game unless you were truly in a cast, unless you truly broke a joint or a bone in your body. There was no such thing as load management during his time. Dr. J came from an era where it was okay to be the villain. Everybody didn't want to be loved. Some guys prided themselves on being the one to make the little kid whose favorite team was the opponent to make that kid cry. Guys prided themselves on silencing the crowd on the road and making little kids cry. Everybody didn't care about being loved. And it didn't matter to those guys. Because in their eyes, if they make the opponent's fans disappointed, that means they're doing good on the court. That means they're taking care of their job on the court. That means they are dominating the opponent on the court. So, we have to get a better understanding of why Dr. J may not have much respect for any of today's NBA players, including LeBron and Steph. This doesn't mean that LeBron and Steph is not great. That doesn't mean that LeBron and Steph can't play in Dr. J's era. Who knows? We'll never know. We'll just never know. But we have to understand that guys like Dr. J come from a different era where the culture was completely different. You had guys that really sincerely cared about basketball and they respected the game. They didn't put women over basketball. They didn't put endorsements over basketball. Now, in fairness, we could say that the money that's available now, it wasn't available to those guys back then. So who knows how they probably would have acted like today's players if the same amount of resources and money and popularity was available to them. Who knows? But we cannot live by who knows and what ifs. We live based on reality and what is and what is not. And reality says that guys from Dr. J's era, basketball mattered. Beating your opponent mattered. Being good on the court and winning championships mattered. It mattered. So when they look at today's NBA players, guys like certain guys can sit out for 80% of the season and still be voted all-star. Guys can miss half of the season and still be an MVP candidate. Guys can go 2 or 3 seasons only playing 20 games and still get big, big contract extensions, $300 contract extension, $200 million, $300 million, $100 million contract extensions by only playing 20 games in 3 seasons. So guys from Dr. J's era is looking like, what kind of league is this? This is not the league that I played in. This is not the standard that I set for the next generation to follow. What has happened to the NBA? The issue is there's a lot of fraudsters in the NBA. There's a lot of frauds. Guys who look like basketball players, but they're not really basketball players. They're imposters. And maybe at one point in their life, they enjoyed basketball, but once they reached the NBA, they have fallen out of love with it. And the reason why they haven't retired is because the money is too sweet. And ownership groups keep offering them more money, enticing them to stay. So I'm asking you, NBA owners, how can you continue to entice players to stay in a league that they don't appreciate? You can't tell us, the fans, that a majority of these NBA stars appreciates the NBA based on their actions. How can you convince us that certain guys appreciates being in the NBA when they rather sit out of games more than play in the games. And then when people from the mainstream media call them out on it, they want to bring up their family. They want to bring up their wife and their kids and their mamas. These players know damn well that when we're talking about you NBA players, we're not talking about your mama. We're not talking about your baby mamas. We're not talking about your girlfriends. We're not talking about your boyfriends. We're not talking about your kids. We're not talking about your daddies. We're talking about your play on the court. And why are you not playing? Why are these teams offering you guys so much money when y'all barely play? We see you guys sitting on the sideline, smiling, laughing with each other, more than playing on the court. And then we're wondering, well, why are they offering these guys this much money if they're not doing much? A majority of NBA stars, they're PR faces. They're I can't think of the right word to say. They're more so models. They're models. They're not athletes. And then when people from the mainstream media point you out on it, you want to get personal, act like somebody's attacking your personal life and your personal character. We, the fans, are tired of NBA superstars, supposedly superstars, deceiving us and robbing our joy from the game. There is no reason why the NFL should be more popular than NBA. Even though NBA plays games in London and Germany and they have fans, you know, in Mexico and in Europe, and now they're starting to gain some new fans in Nigeria. Gridiron football is not a global sport. Basketball is a global sport. And the best of the best basketball players throughout the world look to the NBA and they adore it. But the issue is, you have a lot of players who don't cherish playing in this league. For them, they think it's a right. They don't believe it's a privilege. They think it's a birthright for them to receive so much money from the NBA and barely give effort and barely play. And it's you NBA owners, it's your fault because you enable these guys to have this kind of mentality. It's you endorsers like Nike and Gatorade. It's your fault because you enable these people, these players, to be this way. Guys barely play for 4 straight seasons. They only play like 10 to 15, 20 games. And you're giving them new endorsement deals when they didn't even earn it. Guys who can barely lead their team to the playoffs and they're getting new contracts. NBA owners and you endorsers and you media companies, you created this mess. And now it's your job to clean it up this decade.
Where he'll fit and he'll glow. So he stayed to himself as he set it in the stone. His heart you couldn't clone. Going toe to toe with a steel boot, showing all the courage that he could show. But there's only so much we control as we live in. So the hand he was dealt led to erratic decisions. But none of that mattered if it meant better living. So we went from trapping
to catching little niggas slipping. He was his own team, he was Jordan and Pippen. He never took a L, all he ever knew was winning. He knew that he was tripping, but couldn't get caught slipping. But it all went wrong when he really seen it different. He started to chill, but he was too deep in it. He started to learn life right when his ended. Yes, that's the game of life. In the blink of an eye, you can say goodnight. Oh, no time to prepare to fight. Everything ain't fair in the game of life. No. Oh, 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 yeah. I seen plenty prepare and lose. It's the truth, like it ain't any theirs. I can see many fish out of water wanting air to the throne that they swear is a home that's theirs. I know a dude who you could say wasn't prepared. His book smarts was there, but he wasn't street aware. As he stared at the green that was on the other side, never seen he would fall. That was his biggest demise in my eyes, cause they caught the guy slipping like surprise. And if he was filled with pride, he really wouldn't survive and would have been laying and waiting for eight more lives instead of illing and being on top like child. This game is live, I hope you know this. Keep your drive and keep your focus. Don't deny your golden moments. Life's a ride, you got to know this. Yes, that's the game of life. In the blink of an eye, you can say goodnight. Oh, no time to prepare to fight. Everything ain't fair in the game of life, no. Oh, 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 oh.
Y'all, this is what I am, what makes me, what motivates me lately. I've been asking myself that exact same question. Stand alone in my own section. No glamour, no change, and no fame. It's so strange, it feels like things never gonna change. I write bars with beats banging out in the background to drown out thoughts of losing. Moving from home to parts unknown, unfamiliar chances, advances few and far between. Success is hardly seen, an object hard to gain. It's not a game, I know this. Hate showbiz, but for the home team, I still maintain the focus. I'm not gonna blow my turn, I know it's plenty of dough to earn. Look, 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 yeah, yo, life's a gamble. It's like a test to see how much a brother can handle without flying off the handle. You gotta remain focused, be careful, get the cash in handfuls.
Trying to get mine till it's all done. Trying to give up, trying to give up, trying to get mine till it's all done.
Yo, it's getting dark earlier now, the seasons changing, watching all options. Not many to choose from, it's like either winning or not. I've been given a lot that haven't got back. I know I'm about to collect though, correct foes for not thinking the same. You think you can hang, but think twice. Sometimes this life is just like a roll of the dice. And I don't play them high stakes a lot, cause it takes a lot, and I'm running the snakes a lot. But when you create from the heart, these things happen. I'm trapped in the biz, cold as aspen. Try to move correct, not lose, connect some vex. I'm like one sec from noose and next. My notebook got lines on it, forcing me to cross the lines with words that happen to rhyme on it. On it. Yeah, yo, life's a gamble. It's like a test to see how much a brother can handle without flying off the handle. You gotta remain focused, be careful, get the cash in handfuls. Yo, life's a gamble. It's like a test to see how much a brother can handle without flying off the handle. You gotta remain focused, be careful, get the cash in handfuls.
Trying to get mine till it's all done. Trying to give up, trying to give up, trying to get mine till it's all done. Trying to get mine till it's all done.
See, the object of the game is to win, so I can take the money. May I Before you fly, you gotta run. Before you run, you gotta walk. Before you walk, you gotta crawl. Before you crawl, you gotta be born.
Said I came this far, but you can't go back. Tell me how you feel, cause I really need to know that.
As dust turn to dawn, I keep growing. Seeking knowledge, keep gnawing. Saying cheese without my teeth, Sean. That's right, I'm hot now. Headed to the top now. I got it on lockdown. About to hold my whole block down in Pac Town. Rolling up a dub. Standing cruising. Those with my tunes got the West showing love. See my name on the bills and people showing up. To see me, shit is real, cause I ain't even old enough to buy a lot of tickets. But I guess my motto didn't lie. People don't listen until you really fly. Top five, dead or alive. Thinking I fit the five, but you gon' think I lie. Cause I ain't never hit my eyes. The ill-minded, free will signing. World domination consignment, I co-sign it. I done reached my goal, but I'm not done being a monitor. Underground climbing, they can't dig it, can't
Before you fly, you gotta run. Before you run, you gotta walk. Before you walk, you gotta crawl. Before you crawl, you gotta be born. Said I came this far, but can't go back. Tell me how you feel, cause I really need to know that.
It's the Brooklyn representative, no artificial intelligence. Just thinking enlightened, ain't even take flight yet. I know you feel me, pull out your camcorders. Halves and ounces, just orders. You see your change, it's just my aura. Or in time, I became a reflection of brains, cash, Mary Jane. What did I forget to mention? Well, fat blunt since the age of 15. Y'all smoke toothpicks, I pick the steak out of my teeth. Bon appetit, I'd rather be homesick than homesick. Plastic cups with rubber toast and keep me posted like pics. Not budging the ball and you can't run out of here. Don't blink till you reach the top, keep up with stairs, no competition. Y'all smoke on the regular, my way only high grades. Inhale the indica, exhale the nebula, the cipher secular. No sharing when they offer us, falling up, that's preposterous. Pick up on your chakras, you on the right trail. Come sip that Ciroc with a snow facade. I talk to myself, word to God, put your hands together, no applause. Fuck the law, digress the fall, progressive all. Fuck the rest of y'all, I'm professional. And I'm still dirty.
Before you fly, you gotta run. Before you run, you gotta walk. Before you walk, you gotta crawl. Before you crawl, you gotta be born. Said I came this far, but can't go back. Tell me how you feel, cause I really need to know that.
A couple chips for the meal. That's a lot, though, nothing but crystal dollar bills. The more the merrier, the richer I feel. I'm living ideal. I'm about to throw the tents on my wheels. My homie still leave you still with the steel. That's when shit get real. It all started way back in the day. Took the highway, but still wasn't trafficking weight. So fuck your pass me the J, cause what we happen to play against me, just know you might end up having to pay. Since I'm the champ of the game, smack down a face or just get smacked in your face. Get out of line or get put back in your place. I know it won't be fun having your back in a brace, so just watch what you happen to say.
Before you fly, you gotta run. Before you run, you gotta walk. Before you walk, you gotta crawl. Before you crawl, you gotta be born. Said I came as far, can't go back. Tell me how you feel, cause I really need to know that.
I call it astro-magentum. I woke up in a dream state. This life may seem great, but it ain't. It ain't the first time I seen gray with more high grade. Purple rain for the pain. I said I hate to complain, but lately all I see is days are the same. The ways that it strays could persuade me to change, but I blame it on the game, cause it made me this way. I bet it started when I played CeeLo. 4, 5, 6, then out came CeeLo. A misfit, I've been addicted to the weed smoke. All the youngin' ever knew was reload the demos and steam on. Dream on the plan to put his team on. It's mapped out. We gotta cross the map now. Call the power surge, then we blacked out. I ain't tapping out unless it's blunt ashes and clouds.
Before you fly, you gotta run. Before you run, you gotta walk. Before you walk, you gotta crawl. Before you crawl, you gotta be born. Said I came this far, but can't go back. Tell me how you feel, cause I really need to know that. Before you fly, you gotta run. Before you run, you gotta walk. Before you walk, you gotta crawl. Before you crawl, you gotta be born. Said I came this far, but can't go back. Tell me how you feel, cause I really need to know that.
Now, before I state what I'm about to state, there are only two players that are going to be excluded out of this discussion because they have already put in the work and their effort and their drive and their leadership does not have to be questioned. And that's LeBron and Steph. Now for you other NBA players. What happened to the greatness? What happened to the great American basketball player? What happened to the great American basketball player that all of us look forward to watching? That all of us appreciates his style of play on the court? What happened to that great American basketball player who prides himself on giving the fans their money's worth? What happened to the great American basketball player that shows up every night, regardless of how he feels, just to fulfill his obligation of being a professional basketball player? When we think about the up and coming basketball players that we look forward to seeing, none of them are American. You got Jokic, who doesn't give a damn about American basketball. You got Luka, who doesn't really give a damn about American basketball. You got the new guy in San Antonio. I can't remember his name from the top of my head at the moment. The first round pick from the recent draft in San Antonio. I don't know what his view is towards American basketball. I'm not sure if he's thrilled or excited. You got Giannis. Giannis wants to be great. I'm not sure if he's eager to play American basketball either. Joel Embiid. All of these guys are named non-Americans. Now, it's not a bad thing that they're playing in the NBA, because them playing in the NBA proves that basketball is a global sport, and it proves that NBA is a global league and people throughout the world is watching NBA. But don't you think this is an issue when the top players that we're looking forward to seeing are non-Americans? Now, reminder, LeBron and Steph, I'm not referring to them. They're excluded out of this. They already put the work in. So I'm not referring to them. I'm talking about everybody else, every other American basketball player besides those two. You look at guys like Karl Anthony Towns and Anthony Davis. I'll just call them the Anthonys, the Anthony boys. How you allow guys like Nikola Jokic and Joel Embiid to outperform you? Joel Embiid, he's injury prone. He deals with injuries. But every time he steps on that court, he tries his hardest. He plays with his heart out and he wants to be good. The Anthonys don't have the same kind of fire that Joel Embiid had. If Joel Embiid had the body of Karl Anthony Towns, oh my goodness. Joel Embiid will probably be known as the greatest big man of all time. If Joel Embiid had the durability and the athleticism as Karl Anthony Towns, and he wasn't always injury prone, the rivalry between Nikola Jokic and Joel Embiid will be must-see TV. And they'll get to the point where Nikola Jokic will be forced to leave Denver. Sorry, Denver fans. But if Joel Embiid was not injury prone and he was healthy like Shaq, Nikola Jokic will be forced out of Denver and he'll have to go to Chicago or one of those New York teams, the Nets or the Knicks, because the rivalry between Jokic and Embiid is something that we would want to see every single year as much as possible. Karl Anthony Towns. If Karl Anthony Towns had the heart and the fire as Joel Embiid, Jimmy Butler wouldn't have forced himself out of Minnesota. If Karl Anthony Towns had the heart and the fire as Joel Embiid, Minnesota wouldn't be a play-in contender every single year. They would have a top seed locked. If Anthony Davis didn't fake injuries every year, the Lakers would be championship contenders every single season. It is very disrespectful what Anthony Davis is doing to LeBron James. LeBron James should not be carrying that team on his back. Anthony Davis is supposed to be the one carrying the team on his back. Anthony Davis is supposed to be the face of the Lakers. And now we have another example of what I said earlier during this show. A guy who's been on the team for like 3 to 4 seasons and played only, 40 to 50% of the games, he's about to get a big contract. Another enabling moment in the NBA. LeBron has already put the work in. We shouldn't still be wondering how LeBron is going to lead the Lakers to the playoffs. We shouldn't be having this conversation of how LeBron can overcome Golden State. The discussion should be how is Anthony Davis is going to lead the Lakers to overcome Golden State. But because you have a guy like Anthony Davis who likes to fake injuries, we're still relying on LeBron. And if he's not faking injuries, prove me wrong this season, Anthony Davis. Play at least 80% of the games this season. Because it just makes no sense. You get injured, then you show up, you get injured again. You sit out a couple games, then you come back. You play for 2 quarters, you get injured again, and then you're out for half of the season. But now we're hearing about you getting ready to get a new contract extension. Another enabling moment for the National Basketball Association. And this is the reason why NBA is behind the NFL. And if the NBA is not careful, Major League Soccer is going to surpass it. Now, you may be laughing by what I just said. But keep laughing. Let the NBA continue to enable these grown men, treating them like little kids, allowing them to only play for 20 games a season and still reward them with $200 million contracts. The NBA will eventually fall. We want to be entertained. And us, the fans, we know that the players are ripping us off. The players are sticking their middle finger to us. They're saying we don't give a damn how you feel. The NBA allows me to play whenever I want to play. And they allow me to take a time of leave in the middle of the season whenever I want to. Kyrie Irving, I have a lot of respect for your religious beliefs and what you believe in because you're a grown man. That's not the issue. The issue that us fans have with you is that you just randomly leave in the middle of the season. Each team you go to, it's like it's always some kind of issue. And it's not only you, but the reason why you stand out the most because you're really good. Because you're a really good player, you stand out the most. It's not a personal hate or attack on you, Kyrie. We get mad when you don't play because we love to see you play. It's all love. Our anger, from the fans' perspective, I'm not talking about the media. When the fans get mad at you, Kyrie, it's out of love because we love to see you play. So when we don't see you play, we're disappointed. That's all it is. No personal hate from the fans. The media, that's a different story. You American basketball players cannot get mad at Africans taking your jobs. Because the Africans are hungrier, the Africans want it more, and the Africans are not treating the NBA like it's a right, like the NBA have to let them in. The Africans know that it's a privilege for them to be in the NBA. And I truly hope that Giannis can find some way to overcome whatever it is that's holding him back from being a real dominant player. Because that's the next LeBron in my book. It's not Zion Williams, even though the media really wants Zion to be the next LeBron because, you know, you're an American-based league. So it looks bad for guys from overseas coming over here, dominating your league. It really looks bad. But the problem, your most talented NBA players, they're trying to fit in with a stereotypical image of a black man. And I'm not going to even go there. We all know what's going on with Zion Williams. We all know what's going on with John Morant. The Memphis Grizzlies was a circus this past season. But thank the sports god that they got Marcus Smart going there. And he's going to establish some law and order in Memphis, Tennessee. What happened to the great American basketball player? The guy that took pride in being the best. I'm challenging all you American-born basketball players to get that same kind of heart and desire and fire that Giannis and Joel Embiid have. It would really be beneficial for the NBA. But this won't happen if coaches and medical staff and owners remain married to the load management culture. And I'm gonna talk more about this after this music break.
Yo, you know what we need to do, man? We need to get a gold CD, you know what I'm saying? And get a collection of all the music and everything we ever done.
Bringing back sweet memories. Bringing back sweet memories.
Living in Flatbush and going to house parties. Red lights, bumping life is what you make it, then sorry. In my lifetime, ain't too many things better than watching the first son put his sentences together. Though it kinda make me think of way back when I was the portrait of the artist as a young man. All them teenage dreams of rapping, writing rhymes and napkins. Yeah. It's really visualization making this here actually happen. It's like something coming to me that truly just consumed me. Speaking through the voice of the spirit speaking to me. I think back in the day, I absorbed everything like a sponge. Took a plunge into my past to share with my son. Like thoughts out the back of your mind, going back in some time. Like when you used to cut and had to go to the back of the line. Look back and you find tracks to make you relax and recline. Now cats rap about packing a nine when they lacking divine inspiration. Running out of topics of conversation while I drop it in the pocket, cause rock is my occupation. I do it remarkably, spark up belief, and possibly you can follow me, tap into your chi. Utilize your spiritual faculty accurately. Use your memory to help you see clearly, then get back to me. Actually, nothing's new under the sun, so when life be stressing me, my remedy is like the faces that are woven in the fabric of my consciousness. From cities where making 21's a big accomplishment. Like when my people understood their prominence and my past life visions of the continent. Like the first time I saw KRS Live rocking it, I heard resurrection by common sense. Word. Dominant in my psyche, I chose my direction like Spike Lee to speak my life through mics, and I never take it lightly. It might be something you did to bring you down when you up high. You're that karma as a bitch, you steady asking God why. Like when my parents first split up, yo, I was illin'. Seemed like some years they was together for the sake of the children, and I loved them for that. I don't know if they saw that, so I'ma say it and convey it when the world play it. I'ma say it and convey it when the world play it. I'ma say it and convey it when the world play it. Like black is beautiful. Names from the 70s, let me tap into your energy. Fields of dreams become my property when I reach my destiny, like the prophecy, especially when I'm
bringing back sweet memories.
I dive deeper to my mind, see I got a treasury that float through my head like a sweet melody. What you telling me? Reflection is a collection of memories, definitely. This is how hip-hop is meant to be, eventually. I knew I'd run into high technology. It was only a matter of time, like centuries. Check the recipe or technique to how it sounds so sweet. I freak with word power, my man speak with beats. If I could make it in New York, I figure anywhere I make it. Came to Cincinnati, linked with mood, and we did sacred. High tech beats became my favorite. Hustle on the side was the cut. We started putting songs together like what? Traveled the world, came back to the crib, ain't hit the motherland yet. This year we put in work, I got some other plans. Bet that's where I'll take the fam when the reflection joint is done. By the time you hear this, I'll be basking in African sun like wow. Yes, we made it. We're here.
Hey fellas, where are the treadmills?
Oh, they're right there in the back.
Oh, where is she at? Oh, that's why I love this gym. That's why I love this gym. Woo. Man, forget the bench press today. It is a cardio day for your boy. My goodness, she bad. Holla at you.
I can't lie. I admire beauty like the next man. I still remember when I used to get my check cash, get my hair cut. I hit the streets with my head gas. Looking out for little mamas with a fat fast. That's what my auntie used to tell me. My girl in my rear view trying to tell me. Uh-oh. Cause she knew it wasn't nothing you could tell me. Always on the trail of another female. Well, they say my papa was a player. Somebody's honesty is honest in me, baby. Somehow in college, Greek letters made me cuter all the time online. I still couldn't compute it. I pledged girls, then it's on to the next girl. My next girl eventually be my ex-girl. But it's funny how it all unfolds. I done finally found a woman I ain't never letting go. Whoa.
She looking bad, don't do it. I wonder if she got a man, don't do it. I don't see no wedding band, don't do it. I promise you don't wanna go through it. Look, take it from me. You don't want a problem, you don't want a problem. You don't want a problem, you don't want a problem. And you don't want no problems, G. Find yourself in the obituary column sheet. Yeah.
It ain't nothing like a good woman. If you got you one of those, be good to them. Keep it 100, love everybody want it. But the lies of the lust keep them lying next to us. But I got past it, now I'm known to pass it. Up for my passion and I ain't here blasting. Born sinner just like any other man standing. Couldn't keep the standard, so God sent a standing. If you creeping when you feel desire creeping, I know another way to win that don't involve cheating. Don't involve another heart broken into pieces. When a girl called and tell you that she saw you on Peachtree. Meeting pretty underscore nice features. Had a couple drinks and had yourself a little peace in. Now you're feeling like the man in the streets. Pull up to the crib, see I love your pants in the streets, man.
Ooh, she looking bad, don't do it. I wonder if she got a man, don't do it. I don't see no wedding band, don't do it. I promise you don't wanna go through it. Look, take it from me. You don't want a problem, you don't want a problem. You don't want a problem, you don't want a problem. And you don't want no problems, G. Find yourself in the obituary column sheet.
LaShonda, baby, why are my clothes in the street? What's
oh, you don't know why your pants is in the street? Yeah. Huh, yeah. Shaquita told me she seen you on Peach Street. All up in the girl face.
See, that's,
you
that's
gotta
my,
go.
That's my cousin. That was my sister. I like a friend. My sister. It's like,
no, I don't want to hear
it's
it.
It's like a friend.
Shut up. Get your stuff and go.
Don't do it.
Bye.
I wonder if she got a man. Don't do it. I don't see no wedding band. Don't do it. I promise you don't want to go through it. Look, take it from me. Find yourself in the obituary column sheet.
We just talk about practice. We sitting here, I supposed to be a franchise player, and we in here talking about practice. I mean, listen, we talking about practice. Not a game, not a game, not a game. We talking about practice. Not a game. Not the game that I go out there and die for.
I heard those who can't teach. Well, fuck it, I guess class dismissed. I can't teach you shit. I've been doing this for years, man. My rep is legit. It's like a mic is a cancer stick. I can't quit, but I can kick that measuring stick. Stick that lets you know real quick whether you can or can't spit. And from the sound of it, you on a stage is like a square on a triangle. Hold it, don't fit. I mean, the whole way you trying to hold the mic. I ain't trying to be a smart aleck, but you sound like a dick. It shouldn't be so phallic. You wanna be hard, but you can't come I'm correct. I'd have showed you how it's done if you showed some respect. Instead, what you doing is showing you new in this. Why you pursuing the skill trade? You're trying to get paid and laid before the groupies in the guap, man. The fact is, it takes practice.
We talking about practice. I mean, listen, we talking about practice. Not a game, not a game, not a game. We talking about practice. And we talking about practice. Not a game. We talking about practice, man.
I heard it's better to be lucky than good. Well, in my case, I guess I'm lucky and good. I heard if not for bad luck, Jay would have no luck at all. To which my reply is, fuck all of y'all. I've been passed up, gassed up, bounced around, man. Thrown off the glass just to see what's this. I have yet to score big like Allen Iverson. Maybe someday Jay could endorse a pair of kicks. But for now, long as I can afford a pair of kicks in the closet to put them in, I'ma put them on and walk these dogs. Get my hustle on. Break bread for my youngins so they grow up strong. That's why the flow grow after each and every show, and year after year bring song after song. I heard amateurs keep doing it till they get it right, but pros do it so much we can't get it wrong. That's practice.
We talking about practice. I mean, listen, we talking about practice. Not a game, not a game, not a game. We talking about practice. And we talking about practice. Not a game. We talking about practice, man.
I heard some old colloquialism stating if you love what you do for a living, you never work a day in your life. Yeah, right, but I know what they mean. Some jobs are trapped me like prison. But if you hating me, cause all you do is process and file. Jealous because I get to make beats, spinning freestyle as if I haven't had to work in a while. Like I ain't shedding blood, sweat, tears, stomach acid and bile. Like my workload isn't unbelievable. CEO, COO, accounts payable and receivable. Chief marketeer and manager, sales rep, tour van driver, baggage handler, shit. Like I ain't trying to outsource and delegate. How else you think I ever upgrade or elevate? But at this point in time, I got two options. Get it done right myself or get relegated back to a spot where I do it for fun. In my spare time, oh wait, I won't have none. So don't come at me about that get a real jobby job. We gon' have a problem, see? This ain't a hobby, it's a practice.
We talking about practice. I mean, listen, we talking about practice. Not a game, not a game, not a game. We talking about practice. And we talking about practice. Not a game. We talking about practice, man. We just talk about practice. We sitting here, I'm supposed to be the franchise player, and we in here talking about practice. I mean, listen, we talking about practice. Not a game, not a game, not a game. We talking about practice. Not a game. Not the game that I go out there and die for.
Yeah, baby. Yeah. Woo! Back again.
That's right.
Luda. Feel this. It gets meaner and meaner each time, baby. Feeling real good, too.
Holla at him.
What up, Uncle Face? Yeah. I'm a bull of this industry, man.
Tell him.
Some would rather run down and get one cow.
Nah.
I think I'd rather walk down and get them all. You know what I'm talking about, right? Look. I'm never going nowhere, so don't try me. My music sticks in fans' veins like an IV. Flows poison like ivy. Oh, they grimy. Already offers on my sixth album for labels trying to sign me. Respected highly. Hi, Mr. O'Reilly. Hope all is well. Kiss the plaintiff and the wifey. Drove through the window, the industry supersized me. Now the girls see me in the rivers, what they cry me. I'm on the rise, so many people despise me. Got party ammunition for those trying to surprise me. It's a celebration and everyone should invite me. Roll with the crew or meet the bottom of our Nikes. Exploring like Dora, these swipers can't swipe me. My whole aura so mean in my white tee. Nobody light-skinned, reppin' harder since Ice-T. You disagree, take the Tyson approach and bite me.
Whoa, don't slip up or get cut.
Why not, man?
I'm coming for that number one spot.
All right.
Woo. Rappers swearing they on top.
Man,
scheme, plot, plot.
Say what?
I'm coming for that number one spot.
Woo! hotter than Nevada. Ready to break the steering column on your Impala. If I get caught, bail out Popo, I tell him holla. In court, I never show up like Austin Powers, Faja. Father, father, and hey, I love gold. But can buy anything I want from the records I've sold. Jacuzzi hot, Cristal is so cold. Neighbors catch contact from the blunts that I roll. A pig and a blanket, a smoke and a pancake. Drop albums nonstop once a year for my fans' sake. I crush mics until my hand breaks. Then shag now and shag later till these women can't stand straight. The Ludermeister got them feeling so randy. I'm double XL, so I call them my eye candy. Brush my shoulder and I pop my collar, cause I'm worth a million, gazillion, fulfillion dollars.
Whoa, don't slip up or get cut.
Why not, man?
I'm coming for that number one spot.
All right.
Woo. Rappers swearing they own tub.
Uh-uh.
But I'm coming for that number one spot.
All right, man.
Scheme, scheme, plot, plot.
Say what?
I'm coming for that number one spot.
Woo.
Hey, keep it going, it won't stop.
What you doing, man?
I'm coming for that number one spot.
Causing lyrical disasters, it's the master. Make music for mini me's, models, and fat bastards. These women trying to get me out my pelly pellies. They strip off my clothes and tell me, get in my belly. Stay on the track, hit the ground running like Flojo. Sit back in time and I never lost my mojo. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Ludacris sent down to take over the whole world.
Whoa, don't slip up or get cut.
Why not, man?
I'm coming for that number one spot.
All right.
Woo. Rappers swearing they own tub.
NBA owners might have found the kryptonite to load management, or might I say the solution. That's a better word. The solution to load management. And that's the play-in tourney and also the in-season tourney. But I'm going to talk more about the play-in tourney, because the in-season tourney is still brand new. That's going to be another discussion for another time in one of my monologues. You see, the reason why the play-in tourney could be the solution to load management is because from a fan's perspective, we don't have respect for teams that have to play in the play-in tourney. From a fan's perspective, we view teams that are in the play-in tourney as teams who are lousy throughout the regular season, teams that struggled mightily during the regular season, and they needed help to make the playoffs, which is why they're in the play-in tourney. So, we don't have respect for players and teams who made the playoffs through the play-in tourney. As a matter of fact, teams that make the playoffs through the play-in tourney, we expect them to get bounced out of the first round of the playoffs. You see, with this play-in tourney, key players have to play more games than before. Because even though we don't respect the teams that make the play-in tourney, we we definitely don't have respect for teams that don't even qualify for the play-in tourney. So it's worse for you not to even qualify for the play-in tourney. For you to, you telling me you didn't make the playoffs and you couldn't even qualify for the play-in tourney? Why are you in the NBA? So that's the questions we're going to start. We're going to start questioning these players because the mainstream media, they've allowed the players to, they allowed the players to cause them to stop doing their job. They allowed players and outside forces that are not into sports to cause them not to do their job anymore, which is to promote the entertainment aspect of the game. And the way you promote the entertainment aspect of the game is by criticizing players when they're not playing to their potential. But you allow these players to falsely accuse you of attacking their wives and their girlfriends and their children when you're just talking about their play on the court, their lack of production on the court, and they take that as you're assaulting my mother. Look, that don't fly with us, the fans. It don't fly with us on YouTube. And it doesn't matter how many players like Kevin Durant, they can try to argue with people on Twitter. They can go to someone's Twitter space. They can comment on someone's YouTube channel. That's not going to stop us, the fans, for criticizing you players when you're not living up to potential. The play-in tourney could eliminate the amount of games that players decide to do a load of management on. And the more the fans start to ridicule players for sitting out of games, the more the fans start to ridicule players for being in the play-in tourney, they're either going to do one or two things. They're either going to play better or they're just going to retire. Because NBA players are extremely sensitive and they all want to be loved. So when they're not being loved, they throw temper tantrums and they start to create false accusations that people are talking about their wives and their girlfriends and their baby mamas. Once a player starts doing that, you know his mind is not focused on basketball. Because a player who's focused on basketball, they know, they understand what fans are talking about when we're criticizing your play on the court. You don't relay your criticism or your skill. You don't relate that to somebody talking about your mama. We're talking about basketball. We don't care about your mama and your girlfriends. We're talking about you, the basketball player, because we are paying to watch your league. We're paying money out of paying these subscription costs on our laptops and our cell phones to be entertained. So when we are not getting our money's worth from a bunch of millionaires, we are very disappointed. So when we criticize you players, and y'all start talking about, I got a wife, I got a kids, we're like, what are you talking about? We're talking about basketball. We're talking about your job. You're not doing your job. And load management has caused these players to get too relaxed. They are too relaxed. They are too comfortable. They're too complacent. And maybe the play-in tourney can be the thing that lights a fire amongst these players to take your job serious. You know, another thing that I could talk about is the contracts not being guaranteed, but I'm not going to get too much into that because I'm not a businessman. So I can't really talk too much about that. But I could question if the contracts were not guaranteed and players can just get cut immediately from missing a certain amount of games because they voluntarily chose to miss games. I wonder if these guys will approach the game much more differently. See, I'll close on this. NBA, you allowed this mess to happen. You enabled these guys, treat them like kids, always give them a pat on the back, always tell them it's okay when it's not okay. You don't mind them missing 50 games a year after their 3 or 4 year contract is up and they only play like 10 to 20 games during the course of those 4 seasons. You offer another big time contract. Like, NBA owners, what kind of league do you want this to be? Do you want this to become the Harlem Globetrotters? Like, seriously. Because NBA this past season, it was a circus. Or maybe the past couple of seasons. Maybe ever since Kobe Bryant retired, NBA turned into a circus. Or maybe since the Golden State Warriors cooled off in the past decade. You gotta fix this mess, NBA. NBA owners, because you created this. You, along with the media and your sponsors, your major sponsors like Nike and your political allies, all of y'all created this mess. Because you want these guys to focus on other things besides basketball, including you, hip hop industry. All of y'all created this mess. You want these guys to be activists. You want these guys to be pastors. You criticize them for every single social issue that goes on in this world. Y'all always want an NBA player to say something about it when we already have people who's equipped and prepared to take on these issues. We already have enough activists. We already have enough pastors. We already have enough politicians to handle the social issues that's going on in this world. But y'all want NBA players to deal with it. As a result of that, a lot of these guys can't focus on multiple things at once. A lot of these guys can't be like LeBron James. LeBron James can touch on these issues and still be great on the court. Steph Curry can address a lot of these issues and still be great on the court. Every single basketball player cannot be like those two guys. They're just not it. So all of you people, all of you that I just called out, you NBA owners, you major media, like ESPN, you political groups, like the Democrat Party and BLM and all you other social equity groups, that's been forcing these players to get their mind off of the game, to get their mind off of their craft, that's been preventing them from maximizing their talent and being the man that God created them to be. All of y'all that's been distracting these players. You and the NBA owners, y'all gotta fix it. There is no reason why guys from overseas come to America and outperform American-born basketball players. That is an embarrassment on American basketball. That's an embarrassment on the AAU industry, an embarrassment on the high school industry, an embarrassment on the collegiate industry, an embarrassment to academies like IMG Academy. It's an embarrassment. How we spend all this money to make sure we have the best basketball players in the world, but you got guys from Europe and Africa coming to America and outperforming American basketball players. It's an embarrassment. And you NBA owners, y'all gotta fix it because you guys enabled it.
Yeah, all right. so my voice could, the beat could come down a tiny, tiny bit and my voice could come up a lot.
Yeah.
I can't be no better than the cake. My bad, I don't want no way, no. We got the juice, we got the crew. Mama always told me don't waste your time. I can't be no better than the cake. My bad, I don't want no way, no. Knock on wood, it's gonna be a long life. Stay moving forward, don't waste the soul.
Stay moving forward and elevate from the floor. And the old you had big drive, the new you drive like DeLorean. Until you do more than Lauren,
yeah.
The future's important. They tell me do what you can, man. I'ma do it like Jordan.
That's right.
Gotta check myself, mama. Told me just like old Morgan, free man.
Free man.
The caged bird sings a song for freedom.
Freedom.
Going borderline crazy thinking about the children. Michael Jackson told us all get off the wall back then. Ain't no strings like Tito, no puppet Danny DeVito. It's short idle time, get you nowhere unless you Barino. I ain't a new slave, my new way, the new Negro. Ain't on the web, but it's W.E.B. Keyholes unlocked, no thinking toxic.
That's right.
You miseducated like Lauren with the locks in. If you confuse my boxing with me being boxed
never.
In, it's my native language, ain't gotta say it in moccasins. Whatever I be rocking in, I speak the truth, like 222 times 2, yeah. That's 444,
yeah.
Better than before. Be three times the lady like we sang in Commodores. Knowing I can't
be no better than the cake.
Ooh-hoo.
My bad, I don't want no way, no. We got the juice, we got the crew. Mama always told me don't waste the time. I can't be no better than the cake.
Ooh-hoo.
My bad, I don't want no way, no. Knock on wood, it's gonna be a long life. Stay moving forward, don't waste the soul.
Can't be no bird in a cage.
I can't be that.
Can't let emotions hold me prison to rage.
I can't do
every
that.
Every time they pop off, I don't even engage.
I can't say
knowing
that.
Knowing if I act up, I ain't acting my age.
I don't
some
play
days
that.
Are more fears, other times I'm just like trade. Which means some days I need saving, other days I wear the cape.
Yeah.
They tell me in due time when even babies come late.
Talk about it.
So I'ma go for mine, cause I ain't got none to waste.
That's right.
Born ready like I came out in some cleats, double lace. To run the world with. They tell me it's gonna be a long way.
It's a long way.
Knock on wood that we make it through today. I ain't the one to cross, I left that burden to Lecrae.
Yeah.
I got a plot for every block until I'm king, like Luke Cage, a super. That's my word, the only time to relate.
Cage bird.
So many, many, many moves to make.
Yeah.
And I approach them like Michael on a Motown stage. I walk the moon before I walk the graves all day.
Come on.
Delay nothing, sister, you ain't got no time to waste singing.
I can't.
You can't what?
Control.
Can't be no better than the cake. My bad, I don't want no way, no. We got the juice, we got the crew. Mama always told me don't waste your time. I can't be no better than the cake. My bad, I don't want no way, no. Knock on wood, it's gonna be a long life. Stay moving forward, don't waste the soul.
My heart is a piercer.
sky is black, and I can feel cold steel when I turn my back. It stings like needles with a jagged tongue. You know this rain reminds me of when I was so young. I never had any of those black, hey, Capricorn days. Though it doesn't seem so, I've got to get this way. I'm going through a black, hey, Capricorn day. And though you wanna check me out, I'm not the man to play, 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 play.
Hey, 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 hey,
that's me, baby. Come on.
Hey, 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 hey.
It's like that, like that, like that.
Hey, 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 hey.
Ronnie is on the track, y'all.
Feeling it would be like this. Black Capricorn and a game to represent. Great situations that might get a chance. My mama said that there'd be days like this. She said, flip the situations because people occasionally slip. But you can't control every situation you're in. This is some advice from being used to tell a friend and sit back, relax, enjoy musical blends.
Hey, 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 hey.
It's like that.
Assume the outcome is safety and permanent housing. I roam with a falcon, a tree spotted taught me accounting. I'm about to get these white people caught up in they better lies. Webster dictionary cries, colonize native tongue. Missionary Bible belt, motherland overrun. My gun heavy, I'm about to unload. This is an ode to Haiti, Mozambique, Martinique, Trinidad, Grenada, wherever black people sleep. Pray for them, pray for me, pray for me, pray for me.
The sun will shine. So if we put up a fight, everything will be just fine.
I'm not gonna lie, I'm not surprised to hear the Fugees. It's FBI, we be weaponized. Told my niggas inspect text and inspect the best disguise. Can't eat the food due to special effects of the pesticides. Traded in our fears of a white god in exchange for eternal pride. This Kalashnikov kill crackers, banana mags send his ass back to the Caucasus Mountains. Control burns, got me forewarned about water fountains. For four O's, I'll get you forwards, not you moving backwards. See, this means G.O.D. giving orders directly. Gaining obsessive decadence, getting over depressions. Gifted open, develop while giving hope in these lessons. I tend to spoken aggression. Don't Don't need no scope, no compressor, my voice be my only weapon. Been this for black women and children only like Rosewood. Except I left no one behind and didn't need a cracker to do it. Creating a path of safe passage to do it. Baby, my black is the truest. You pray for me, I pray for you back to imbue it.
Storm will come, we'll best believe the sun will shine. So if we put up a fight, everything will be just fine. We go through the ups and downs and in and outs, that's just life. But if we put up a fight, everything will be just fine.
We're gonna be just fine.
Just fine. Keep on working.
I remember stadiums so packed, the trees outside the gates heavy with black joy. Just to get a glimpse of the comrades, our boys back from the bush. The crowd swayed to the gospel of liberation, poised for revolution. Little red book in my father's breast pocket, the ground shook. History moving underfoot, I was on his shoulders on tenterhooks. The leader spoke slow and focused, powerful pauses flanked by soldiers with dead eyes. The sun catches wire-rimmed glasses, told him roll the boulder. Lo and behold, Lazarus was alive. Squinting the light, stinking to death, mouth dry, red dust, a ghoulish prize. They never say what happened after, no surprise. Could've guessed what happened to us, but at the time, mesmerized by MiG-23s in the sky, sonic booming. I'll never forget the rush of pride. Women ululating, men drunk, strong spirits, dueling drums, the callous thumbs of Imbira players, the ride home at dusk, faring students and strangers, feeling like we won. Roadblocks manned by mere boys, wide smiles and long black guns.
Whether or not you understand it, this is the plot, this is the end. Cutty on my speakers again. Pop a script that got me ripping up my pages. These words won't live forever, so a nigga gotta make them. Higher seven seals on the real, cook with the apron. Today I'm feeling Cajun, a haven made for a pagan. Yeah, was infiltrated by niggas, need me a Glock or something. Shock a nigga, leave the sock on top and rock it to him. This was the 80s, I be flipping packs in the locker room. Raised by Reagan babies, we taught them maneuver fumes. Spatula moves, hoping this bourbon will resurface. Spatula flipping writtens into the oven furnace. Brick by brick, I tore it down like the crucifix. That pin me down as a youngin' going through some shit. Thoughts in the sewer, now I'm really going through some shit. And it's no hard, and it's no hard, yeah. And it's no hard feelings, yeah. And it's no hard feelings. I'ma get this money without you. I'ma get to drink. Out you, nigga, hold me up, and it's no hard feelings, yeah, and it's no hard feelings. I'ma get this money without you, yeah, get to drinking without you, nigga, hold me up, get used to it. Flew off the rail, nose grind, unamused to it. You are the muse that I amuse until the AM. Refusing to sleep, cause these raps do pay him. By them, I mean the bodies that I'm slaying. Gatekeepers, whack niggas on the FM, so F them, no, fuck y'all niggas. Crowd favorites, so they sent me here to murk y'all niggas. Contracted in a cage with your face off, nigga. Been a time I only had a parking ticket to my name. What you fabricate won't activate inside the lane I'm in. I mean, the man's is worth nothing, bring the bag and keep it dumping. I see headlines in my future, but how a nigga flexing a ball size of loofahs. A roofie in the coupe with 20 women from Bermuda. Super soaker ho repeatedly went dipping with a scuba. Who the fuck is you, bruh? West Orlando from the Bandos to the Barnett. Park far from you lanes if you a target. Scope feels safer from a range, kill your Margaret. Skill wise, we are margins away. Class of my own, like Margiela skates. I scarf as I blow fumes, grown out of state. State prop, we the chain gang running up the block, nigga. And it's no hard feelings. Yeah, and it's no hard feelings.